Superhuman. A superhero adventure. Written by J.A. Cipriano. Narrated by Luke Daniels. Chapter 1. Behemoth Man was one of the most recognizable heroes in the city, and for good reason. He was immensely strong, tougher than steel, and brutally efficient at pummeling villains into submission. His trademarked combat moves were known and feared by metahumans everywhere because he wasn't particularly choosy about using them against friends or foes. And he was really beginning to piss me off. The blue-clad bully was creating quite a buzz inside the diner. Most were shocked at how intimidating he was up close, or speculating on who he might be under his mask. But all I could see was the way he kept grabbing at the backside of the weary server who kept ferrying him plate upon plate of food. He pushed away from the front counter without paying and gestured down to his silver swim trunks.
"You should definitely give me your number, sweetie. I'm big all over, if you know what I mean."
She mumbled something noncommittal and tried to squeeze past him, which only gave the super jerk a chance to grind against her. I sighed and popped the last of my donut into my mouth, chewing thoughtfully. Normally, I try and ignore the way some of the capes in the city acted, but this was too much. The poor waitress couldn't exactly fight a bum like this off. At best, she'd get fired for costing the diner free advertising, and at worst, he'd deck her as surely as he would a rampaging supervillain. Somebody was gonna have to put this guy in his place, and no one else here could. Which meant it would have to be me.
"You should apologize,"
I said around a mouthful of donut as I came up behind the Cape Crusader and put my hand on his shoulder.
"To the waitress."
The diner fell silent, the faint creak of leather and spandex filling the void where the late afternoon chatter had been a moment ago.
"You should mind your own business, bub."
The humongous brute snorted, turning to look down at me from just inside the entrance to Donuts and More.
"No one asked your opinion. Now back the fuck off before I turn you into a smear."
"I'm really gonna have to insist." I pointed to the waitress who'd been pressed against the wall, trying to escape the massive hero. "Apologize." 20 pairs of eyes flickered between myself and the hero, their food forgotten.
"Make me."
He grinned at me, huge white teeth glinting in the light of the diner, the toothpick clamped between them looking like a splinter. A few of the patrons in the closest booths were quietly trying to escape from their seats. "Step outside, then," I shrugged. "I don't want to mess up this place. They have the best crullers in town."
"Are you being serious?"
he asked, confused. He jabbed a finger the size of a sausage at the bee plastered across his massive chest.
"Don't you know who I am?"
I looked him up and down impassively, taking in his swollen physique beneath the blue and silver tights, the array of crime-fighting gizmos hanging off of his belt, and the dull, cruel face that was plastered on a dozen different billboards across town. "Well,
clearly, you mustn't, so let me inform you,"
he interrupted.
"I'm Behemoth Man, and I'm the strongest, most powerful hero in this dump of a city."
He took a step toward me so that he loomed over me, his immense bulk dwarfing me.
"And you want me to step outside with you?"
"Preferably," I nodded to him. "Otherwise, I might wreck this place, and that isn't my intention."
"Okay, bub, fine."
He ruffled my hair, his huge hand palming my skull like a basketball.
"Let's step outside so you can defend the lady's honor."
He shot a glance at the red-headed waitress.
"I'll be back in a minute, sweet cheeks."
With that, he strode past me, squeezing his enormous frame through the doorway, and as the sound of the entrance bell rang in my ears, the waitress gripped my arm. "You don't have to do this. He does it all the time. It's okay, really." "No, ma'am. It isn't okay," I shook my head. And the fact that he always does it is worse. He'll kill you. She looked down at her shoes, her shaking voice barely above a whisper. His behemoth punch once knocked out Miraculous Man. I can take a punch or two. I shrugged and walked out the door to find the superhero standing a few feet away, leaning casually against a car. As I approached, he got to his full 8-foot height and marched over to me like he was used to intimidating people with his size.
Ready to die, punk?
He asked, spitting his toothpick at me. Not particularly. I looked at my watch. I have to pick up my laundry in a few minutes. Mr. Chow hates it when I'm late.
Oh, a wise guy.
Behemoth Man took a step back, rolling his swollen shoulders, his muscles shifting beneath his uniform to let me know he was about to go for his patented super serious behemoth punch.
We'll see how wise you are when you're eating meals through a straw.
You know, when I was little, I wanted to be a hero. I said, right before Behemoth Man's ham-sized fist crashed into my face, flinging me backward as a sonic boom echoed through the air. I smashed into a parked car half a block away, denting the metal inward and shattering the windows as the vehicle tipped up sideways. As it crashed back down on its wheels, I found my footing, dusted myself off, and smiled at the Caped Crusader. The surprise on his face more than made up for how much that hurt. Then I realized something. No one wants to be around a guy like me. Not heroes, not villains. I began walking toward him, glass crunching softly under the soles of my shoes. See, I make them uncomfortable. Make them realize what's what.
How are you still standing?
Behemoth Man asked, one golden blonde eyebrow arching above his silver mask in confusion.
That punch should have turned you into a smear.
It probably would have, if I couldn't absorb metahuman abilities for myself. He hadn't realized I was using his own strength against him yet, but he would, soon enough. Yeah, should have is the key part, I said, knocking my own chin with my knuckles. See, gods don't like to fall, and what you're experiencing right now, the fear, the anxiety, it's what I love most about my job. I smiled. The hero laughed, striking a combat stance as I approached.
I'm not afraid of you. In fact, I'm glad it's not over with just one punch.
He flexed, his muscles practically bursting the seams of his skin-tight silver suit.
Come over here so I can hit you again.
Are you sure that's what you want to do? Or would you rather give up? Live to fight another day, perhaps? I pointed my finger at him. You can't beat me. So I'll give you one chance, hero. Lay down your arms. Give up the way, the truth, and whatever other bullshit you pay lip service to. If you do, you won't die here tonight.
I'm a class A hero, asshole,
he snorted as the crowd of onlookers started to gather. Soon there would be sirens, news vans, the works. Then things would get dicey. I always looked horrible in photographs.
Do you know what that means?
It means you get a heavy stipend from the Hero Society to police the streets. It means you think you're better than all those beneath you. I nodded back toward the donut shop. It was obvious from the way you treated the waitress. I curled my hand into a fist. Someone's gotta teach you that isn't right.
What are you talking about?
He asked, and as he looked at me, I recalled the events that started this whole mess. It had been a bunch of little things, maybe, but heroes like this get so full of themselves that everything became a little thing. Him grabbing her ass after she asked him to stop. Him telling her to relax because he was a big-time hero. Him not even offering to pay. They never faced any consequences for treating normal folks just trying to do their jobs like they didn't matter. You didn't even leave her a tip, did you? I asked, stopping just outside the big man's reach. The waitress?
What does that have to do with anything?
He glared at me and I could see his muscles starting to tense. He was gonna hit me again. That was gonna hurt. Everything. I looked back toward the crowd, nodding slightly toward the waitress. This is for you. He swung at me again, the paragon of power shifted, his entire body weight driving into the blow as his fingers...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.